In this video, we will follow our documentation article on integrating an HTML5 report viewer in an ESP.NET Core 5 Web API application. We will assume that we already have a working Telerik Reporting REST service running in another project. We're going to display the barcode's demo report, so let's add it in the Services Reports folder. Let's add a new .NET 5 web project. This is where we will host the report viewer. We need to serve static files, like for example the report viewer's JavaScript file. Add the Use Static Files option in the startup configuration if it's not already there. Let's add a new web page for displaying the report viewer. Copy and paste the sample code from the documentation article into a new HTML file. We need to update the references to our existing REST service. Navigate to the properties of the service project and copy the debug base URL. Then paste this in front of the existing relative paths. There are two references that we need to update. First is in the service URL option of the viewer, and second is in the script reference for the report viewer's JavaScript file. The web page is ready, let's save it. We can make the web page containing the report viewer the default launch page. We need to set the two projects to be started together by Visual Studio, as they need to be run simultaneously. Once this is done, we can test the solution. When running the solution, the result is an error indicating that we have an enabled course in the REST service. Let's go to the REST service setting documentation article and enable course. First, we need to register a new course policy in the startup file of the REST service project. Then we can apply the policy to our service. Let's test the solution again. This time, the report is displayed as expected. Let's also try with another report that connects to a database. By doing so, we can check whether the connection works. Everything seems to be working as expected.